Hey guys, it's Omega, and today I am making a video on how to take amazing pictures of Forza Horizon 4. Just like I did in Forza Horizon 3, I'm doing it for this one now, because my last one did pretty damn well. So I was like, I'll do this one. I mean, that one got over a couple of thousand views. I could probably get some on this one too, maybe, and you know, maybe get some subscribers. So I'm gonna be teaching you how to take amazing pictures. Yep. I'm just gonna repeat myself throughout this video too, like an idiot. Okay, so to take amazing pictures, right? First, you need Forza Horizon 4. That's a must. And you also need an Xbox or a PC to play this game on. If you have Forza Horizon 4 and a PlayStation, you're a fucking idiot. I'm kidding. I don't know where to go from here. Okay, let's get on with taking an amazing picture, right? Okay, photo mode is P. Of course, that makes sense. And controller, it is up on the D-pad. Okay, so you want to press the up button. And you'll be taking this. So I will, you know, quickly run you down through the effects and what they all do and how you should do it. This is kind of bright too, so I need to fix that. It actually doesn't look too bad. Look at that. Oh, it looks a little blurry. Hold on. There you go. That looks nice. That's how you take a good picture. No, I'm kidding. Okay, so. Shit, I keep pressing the wrong button. Okay, so. Yeah, let's teach you how to take amazing pictures. So, shutter speed. Okay, I'm gonna need to be moving to show shutter speed. I have my drift Mustang, so okay, and boom. So shutter speed is basically this blur you see. I don't really know how to explain it. You could also just watch my last video. I think I was smarter back then. So shutter speed is basically how fast the camera's lens is moving and how well it can capture the movement. Oh my god, this actually looks pretty good already. The camera mode in this game is pretty damn good. The panning and, the focus mode on this, I don't exactly know how it works yet. Forza did recently update the photo mode. Before the update, it was a lot like Forza Horizon 3's photo mode. This one's a little different. So I assume panning, if I get rid of this, it behaves differently. I can't... I don't know on this one. You might want need to seek a professional, which is not me. Tracking is probably the easiest one to understand. Is basically... Whoops. No, not... Wherever you have your circle pointing and you press focus, you'll kind of track that object you choose. So I clicked on, I'm focusing on the car, so the car is all in focus while the background is blurred out. And especially near the car, the further out you get, it's less blurred because usually it's kind of more static over there and you can't really blur out the thing. You have to be like really moving to blur out the background too. Plus the photo would look kind of weird. Yep, okay, focus. Honestly, it's just how much focus you're adding. So if you do that, it controls more of the blur as well. Honestly, you don't need to use it if you're just pressing X to focus something. So exposure is like how much light is getting into your camera's lens. So the lower you go, the less light gets into that until you get a very dark picture. And obviously 100 is... Oh, this is really slow. I should just use a mouse. Yeah. See... I'm on PC, so yeah, I finally got a good PC so I can run this game on. So, seizure warning. So 100 is max brightness and 0 is least brightness. You need to fix that. I'm saying a lot in this, aren't I? So, fuck. How to use exposure in different light settings is basically up to what time of day it is. If it's night or it's a very dark day, you kind of want to have your exposure up higher. You kind of want to bounce it out so you can see a majority of your photo. You don't want to have really dark areas unless that's what you're going for. Like, because sometimes having areas too dark just looks pretty crap. And in the day, you want to like lower it a bit because you don't want your lights to be blown out and just looking too bright. It'll look bad or cartoony, especially if you're going for something like a photorealistic style. So yeah, next is aperture. If I remember how I explained in the last video, aperture is like if you got a picture of something and kind of like if you got a picture, duplicated it, and then move the picture slightly to like the left or right, and you get this like double picture look to it. It's that basically. That's how I remember it. Let's see how it actually looks. No, it just adds more blur, I guess. No, yeah, no, it is blurring. It's grabbing a bunch of pictures in the background. Like if you look at the mountain, see how it blurs out? It's like it's grabbing picture, pasting it multiple times and blurring it out like that, kind of. God, I suck at this. Did it so much better in the last video. Okay, go have a look at that. So I'm not gonna give you like the numbers to each thing, like how much exposure you need or how much aperture you need. It's really up to personal taste. It's how you feel like it. Honestly, you could probably pretty easily make a really good photo without knowing how to use these tools. It's just move the sliders around. It looks nice. Take a picture. That's it really. So bokeh or bokeh, bokeh. Bokeh shape is like you know how in those lights in the background that are blurred and have this like cool circly blur look to it? That's what bokeh is, and you can change what shape those lights have. So you can have like a circle, diamond, or pentagon or hexagon look to them. So yeah. Sampling is probably more like the post-processing that will happen on your picture once you take it. Like if you have it on quality, when you press take photo, it's gonna take a while to process. Trust me, I did it yesterday on the Xbox. I had this amazing picture of the Northern Lights and stuff. It looked cool. If you want it to be fast, it will quickly you know, process the video. Obviously, if you look at the two modes, fast and quality, it's also affecting the anti-aliasing a bit too as well. On fast, the anti-aliasing is slightly more noticeable than quality. And the game is trying to put me in online. I shouldn't be doing that. I'm already uploading a different video. Okay, contrast is like basic. Imagine HDR. It controls the dark areas and the bright areas. Obviously, maxing it out just gives you a white image, and making it black just makes it darker. But it also makes the colors pop a little too. It's really nice. Sometimes you can actually just control it to make your cars look much colorful without screwing up the color saturation as well. Basically, contrast, use it for making the shadows look darker or more defined. Okay, now to color. If I reset this default, look how boring it looks. Okay, it's very flat. Color is well, what, how much color you have when you see you, it's like saturation basically. I guess they could put saturation up there anyway. So it's just your yeah, it's how much color is in your scene. Obviously, if you zero it out, you get grayscale or black and white, as some people call it. And if you want to make it very colorful, you put it on 100. Usually, what I've been told is, if you're going for photorealistic, I think the maximum you should go is like 20% above what it's set to, like 20% plus saturation. So we're at 50%. 20% of 50% would be 10%, I guess. So your max should be about 60, and it looks alright. Plus, you have your contrast to play with that can make the colors pop out without affecting the color of the entire scene. brightness is how bright the scene is. It's very different exposure. It's like, oh my god, oh. This one's not like exposure where how much light goes into a lens. It's actually how bright the overall picture is itself. So as you can see, if you add more bright, it's like if someone was, if you were like on Paint or Paint.net, you know that Photoshop program, and if you got like a white paint bucket and drop the alpha and you just put white on top of it, that's what it's doing. It's just adding white on top of something. And if you're making darker, it's putting black on something, but you know, low alpha. Sepia is basically the good old-timey color to it. Too much can look bad unless you're going for that, but usually it's supposed to look a bit more orange, isn't it? But if you're trying for going for a bit of realism, you want to add a bit of sepia onto it. It's really hard to tell what's the difference between what 0 and 10. Anyway, vignette is the little black stuff that happens near the corners of the screen. The more you have it, the more pronounced they are. Obviously, this is for getting people to look towards the center of the screen instead of the corners. It focuses the viewer's eyes towards the middle, basically, or whatever is in the middle area. It's nice to just have like a slight vignette to it. So, I don't know, it just looks nice. I can't explain it. Temperature is the cool and warm look to it. Middle is neutral, right? If you go towards 100, you're going towards warm colors. If you go towards 0, you're going for cool colors. Up to personal preference or where you are in the scene, if you want cooler colors or warmer colors. These settings are kind of new, I think. It's car's lights. If you look at the Mustang, you can see I'm turning on the lights on and off. At night, this could make a difference if your car's facing the camera, right, but you don't want the car's lights blinding you. You can turn it off and have the car in the background but you'll have to also bump up the exposure so you can see the car without the lights on. And you might need to adjust the contrast, so having too much contrast with high exposure could look odd. Drivers is just... okay, basically, what it does is just gets rid of the driver. Mine's a dude wearing a skeleton exosuit, wearing glasses that make him look unimpressed, and his mustache. Crowd is just hides the crowd and not. Creatures just hides the crowds. I guess that's it. I guess I could tell you one thing is a way to somehow control the environment. So if you want to take a picture in day or night, it's unlike Forza Horizon 3, you can't actually control the day or night cycle because it is technically linked to the online world. So if it's day on online, it's probably day on offline as well. But just to keep it simple, and when you move from offline to online, it's seamless and you don't have a weird transition where you suddenly go to day when you're night. So to keep it simple, it could be different. I could be an idiot and explaining differently. But if you do want to take a picture at a different time of day that you're not in, you can go to an event, start the event, and just take a picture during the event, but that'll be very difficult maybe. You could create a route and then create a custom event and then change the weather through that. So if I went into here, shit. Okay, it just kept it the same. Let's get out of here. Okay, if you didn't care about the explanation and just want to see how to take a cool picture, like just you want me to do it, let's do something. Okay. Damn it, the wheel is straight. Okay. Ooh, that spot looks nice. Okay. Wheel isn't straight anymore. Okay. That looks nice. Oh, the framing looks cool. You see the trail of smoke following the car. And the picture already looks quite nice. But my problem is I have the fucking GPU percentage up there. Just so. What's the streaming? Shit! Okay, let me just do that again. I'm gonna. Where is it? I need to frame rate! Hold on, let me just quickly deal with this.
Yes.
I'm looking at those things, so I can take a pretty good picture. Shit! Alright, I am back! After a bit of a little technical difficulty and a restart. So, let's just have me take a picture really quickly just to show you how it's done. I always take that corner shit. Okay, let's see. I hope. Motherfucker! Okay. So, first thing we're gonna go effects. Shutter speed. We wanna drop that a little. I would say close to 40. Tracking. Focus. I can zero it out. Exposure. Darken it a little. That 40 is good. Aperture. Put 10 onto it. It's nice, blurry. Quality, so that get the extra processing. Contrast, I will bump it up to 60. So, yeah, 60 was good. If you look at the shadows, it gets a little weird looking. So 60 is good. Color 60, yep, it remembered. Brightness, nope. Somewhere near 40 is good. Sepia, put some in there if it does affect the color. Temperature, I think a warmer look might help actually, so put it on 60. It's basically just your sweet spot is basically 50% of the game's original setting sometimes. I mean 20% of the game's original setting. I can turn off the card. I can't do that. Yeah, that's good, and then let's hit the best button in the game. It's like, you fuck around with all the settings, right? You don't know what the thing's gonna look like until you press focus, and it's just the best thing ever. Like, this looks already great, it's like no sneak peek, but once you get it in the right spot, and press X. It looks a little weird on the side, but. Yep, that looks nice. Hit take photo. It'll process based on what system you're running off. It might take a little longer. Wow, that was actually quick. And boom, you have a really cool picture. I might add like a slideshow at the end, showing the other pictures I've taken. I'm not gonna save that though. And that is the end of the video. I put the controller down. Well, yep, that is the end of the video.